So you're looking for email apps that look like Superhuman. Well, today we're going to dive into a few different alternatives for Superhuman on the market. And there are probably two reasons you may have come to this video. Number one, you like the look of Superhuman, but you don't have the budget towards it, which is totally understandable. And not many people do. That's totally fine. And the second is that you may have heard the news that AI writing assistant Grammarly has purchased Superhuman. They also purchased Coda, another all-in-one email app, workspace app over the last couple of months, and that news may have prompted you to be a little bit more cautious. Now, let's hope that you're not here on this video because they've diluted Superhuman and it's no longer an email app. Let's pray that doesn't happen because I personally use Superhuman every day. But for namesake, let's just say that you're looking for an alternative and hopefully it's not shut down. So I'm going to run through some recommendations for you and hopefully you find a solution. All of the apps will be mentioned below. And if you want to browse what apps other people use in your industry or sector, then you go over to Stacks. It's a great way to discover ways that people use tools. It's fantastic. We created it. That's why it's fantastic. So the first app on my list is called Spark Mail, and this is created by a company in the market called Readle. Now, Readle already creates some really popular apps like PDF Expert, Calendars, and many more. And they've been pretty well established in the market. Now, Spark Mail is already used by over 17.5 million people, I believe it is. And it's already got a really good App Store rating. Now, it's available on a wide range of devices, connects with all the popular email services, and it is free to use, but has a premium tier that I believe is priced between $4.99, depending on whether you go annually, or $7.99 per month, which is fairly reasonable, much more approachable in pricing. And it does deliver a really nice user interface. Now, in my opinion, not as nice as Superhuman. However, the application does weave in a lot of more recently AI features as part of its premium. So if you're seeking that smart inbox, AI features for drafting emails, and that little bit of assistance when it comes to sharing and collaborating with team members as part of their additional premium, then you might like Spark Mail. It's sort of this all-round alternative that is just one I typically recommend for all-round use case that don't want to use the basic Gmail, Apple Mail, and those ones. So that's my first recommendation. Number two is probably what I would deem as the best like-for-like Superhuman alternative. It's called Shortwave. And whilst it doesn't have a desktop app that's dedicated, doesn't have Windows or Mac, it does, but they're sort of Chrome apps that bolt onto the Chrome browser. They sort of live as separate apps, but they're not really, they're practically web ported. However, it's probably the best like-for-like alternative. Now, Shortwave, in my opinion, has a lot of good AI features. They've got a little assistant on the side, which you can communicate. That means creating calendar events, also being able to search through your inbox to a set period of time, and to be able to start working on those emails and finding the right ones. Now, I really like there's features in here where you can set up labeling, and for example, it will automatically filter certain emails based on a prompt that you have, which is a really nice feature. And they have tasks in here to help you manage your tasks. And the premium is fairly reasonable. If you've got a Gmail or I believe a .edu account, either one of those, I believe it is, then you can get access to the $7.99 per month plan, which is fairly reasonable as a price for those AI features to get started with. But if you've got a Google Workspace account or beyond, then you're going to have to pay the $14.99 per month and beyond pricing. So this one looks a lot like Superhuman, does have some negatives to the fact that it doesn't have a desktop app, a fully fledged desktop app, but it does have some good mobile apps. So it's well worth considering if you're looking for a like-for-like alternative. So next up is one called Missive. Now, I actually used Missive for about 3 years, and it's not really meant to be a personal productivity slash email client for yourself. I sort of broke the rules on that, but at the same time, a lot of people do use it. It's more of a premium application. I believe the pricing has even gone beyond $15 a month, but it's not going to expand past Superhuman's pricing, I don't think anyway. But it's more designed to be a shared inbox software. So if you and your team are using Superhuman, or you're looking for a shared inbox software where you can assign stuff to other people, leave comments and collaborate on emails, then this is a great one. But I would say it's a great one because the customizations are crazy. You can go into a vast amount of detail on how you want to customize this, connect it with other popular apps, like Todoist and OpenAI's, and there's loads of different integration opportunities there. So this one is a good consideration if you're growing outside and beyond a team and you'd like superhuman sharing abilities. Okay, next up is one that's growing on the market. It's called Canary Mail. Now, again, like Missive, it does have some shared inbox abilities, but it does have a personal app that will help you to use the assistant to organize your inbox a little bit more effectively. So the assistant will help you to create calendar events and do some light AI organizing. Now, I quite like the look of this app. They've had a rebrand recently and they want to be a more of an intelligent email app, but the app is really well or widely available. And it does have, in the more premium pricing, I'll explain those in a moment, does have some security, PGP security setups that you can use to send secure emails. Many people call this one sort of like a Proton Mail alternative versus a superhuman alternative, but the AI element I think you'll quite like. Now there's two pricings if you're not using it as a team. There's a $3 per month pricing, which I think is really reasonable for a lot of the features. You can use it for free, by the way, but there is a $10 pricing for the more premium security focused features for sending end-to-end encrypted emails. So next up is one called Spike. Now this one is great for teams who want to be able to combine Slack with email. It's great for collaborating on documents, tasks, and just being able to share stuff in real time. A lot of people like this because it makes it feel like you're using Slack with your email. Now, one of the things that I don't particularly like about it is the design. So if you're coming from Superhuman, I think the design is a downgrade in terms of what it looks like. It's not necessarily the most attractive in comparison with Superhuman, but the app is fast and it does work as a good combination if you're looking to bring your team into a collaborative tool that you can use to replace Slack and internal email. You can connect up your domain and lots of things like that. Now, it is available in the link in description as all of these apps are. So my final recommendation, I will mention some notable alternatives near the end of the video, is one called Hey Email. Now, if you're somebody that wants to be able to be a little bit more productive on your email, Superhuman did help with that, but this one is a lot more, I guess, different. It changes your perspective on email. So it is designed and managed by a company called 37 Signals. They're the creators of Basecamp. So they're very opinionated about how they set up their productivity software. And it is a really good app. It's available on a wide range of devices. But the only thing that's different is that you get a @hey.com email address domain. So you don't necessarily connect to a Gmail and things like that. You can forward emails in from Gmail and also set up a reroute if you decide to call it a day on Hey. But the application is essentially designed for you to set up from scratch. There's loads of features like an inbox, not an inbox, an inbox, which sets up your important emails, helps you screen out emails, whether that's from newsletters or first-time screenings, and they've got loads more features. And it's all packed into a $99 per year subscription, but it also comes with a calendar app that's built in too. So this is an interesting one. It's very opinionated and well worth looking into. So we have done a full review on it. Like all of these apps, linked below. So some notable mentions on the market. So there's one called Xero. More recently, it's trying to be an AI native email app. I've heard a lot of talk about it. I haven't reviewed it yet, but it looks interesting. It looks attractive, and I think they're going after that superhuman market. The second is Proton Mail. This again is a really attractive option if you're looking for secure email sending, a good Canary Mail alternative. The third is one, if you use a Mac and you use Gmail and you want to combine those two to create a really nice experience. Mimistream, that's what it's called. And it's a really well built, feels native app that you can use on Mac for Gmail. And finally, EM Mail, which is good for both Mac and Windows. So if you're looking for all these apps or you're looking for more, jump over to Toolfinder. We've got loads over on the site if you're interested. They help you find the best email apps on the market. But hopefully we dug a little bit deeper into the world of superhuman alternatives. Very sad. I don't think they'll shut it down, but I hope they don't because I'm a big user. I love it. I spend a lot of time in email every day and I hope that they don't go ahead and do that. So let's pray together. Let's make sure it doesn't happen in the comments. I feel like if it does, people just be berating me in the comments and sharing their thoughts. So thank you so much for stopping by. I hope this video was helpful and I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio for now.